All right. Good morning, Divine Redeemer. Awesome. Nice to see all of you here today. My name is Pastor Adam, and I'm really excited for this chapel today. We're going to be talking about a character in the Bible that many of you probably know. Who knows who Jonah is? Raise your hand. Very good. We're going to be talking about him because he is a guy who had many ups and downs in his life, but through it all, God was faithful. But before we dive into that, I want to introduce you to a very special group who is debuting today. This is their first day doing praise songs here for Divine Redeemer. This is our Eagle Praise Band, and they will be leading us in our Song of the Month. So I invite them to take it away.
Good morning, DR. We are EPB, the Eagle Praise Band.
This is our first performance, and we are so excited to be here.
Please join us by standing and singing our theme song for the year, which is Sing Wherever I Go.
All my life, all I know, God's been good to my soul. Mountain high, valley low, I'm gonna sing wherever I go. All my life, all I know, God's been good to my soul. Mountain high, valley low, I'm gonna sing wherever I go.
God is for me, He's not against me. I will hold to the plans He has for me. When I'm broken, He will fix me. I will call on the name of the Lord. All my life, all I know, God's been good to my soul. Mountain high, valley low, I'm gonna sing wherever I go. He's my heart song in my sorrow. He's my hope and my strength for tomorrow. When the storms rise all around me, I will call on the name of the Lord. All my life, all I know, God's been good to my soul. Mountain high, valley low, I'm gonna sing wherever I go. All my life, all I know, God's been good to my soul. To my soul, mountain up, valley low, I'm gonna sing wherever I go.
Very good job, Eagle Praise Band. Let's give them another round of applause. That was awesome. Great job. Love to see our fellow students leading us in worship together. If everyone would just remain seated, we welcome you here today. And also those who are watching in your classrooms, we welcome you to worship as we worship our God today. So first, we're going to begin with the invocation. And this is something that we do, you're familiar with it, the start of every church service. This is a reminder of our baptisms. When you were baptized, the pastor placed water on you and said, they baptize you in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. So every time we begin this way, we remember our baptism. So we're going to do the same thing today. So we begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now we're going to do some prayers, and what I want you to do, I'm going to say a prayer, and I'm going to say all God's people say, and you will respond saying, "Thank you, Jesus." So let's practice that. All God's people say, "Thank you, Jesus." Very good. Well, let's start. Dear Lord, Heavenly Father, we thank you for this beautiful day that you've given us. We thank you for the opportunity to gather, to worship you, and to learn that you are always with us through the ups and the downs. All God's people say, "Thank you, Jesus." We pray that you would continue to keep us safe, guard and protect all of us, and help us to be a light in your community, showing others about Jesus. All God's people say, "Thank you, Jesus." Amen. Awesome. So to start, what I'm going to do, and I'm going to grab my Bible here, we're just going to read a short section of the book of Jonah. And this comes from a very low point in Jonah's life, where Jonah was in the belly of a great fish, or we could call it a whale. And Jonah prayed to God that God would rescue him. And here is what Jonah prayed to God in the belly of the fish. It writes, "Then Jonah prayed to the Lord his God from the belly of the fish, saying, 'I called out to the Lord out of my distress, and he answered me. Out of the belly of Sheol I cried, and you heard my voice. For you cast me into the deep, into the heart of the seas, and the flood surrounded me. All your waves and all your billows passed over me. Then I said, I am driven away from your sight, yet I shall again look upon your holy temple. The waters closed in over me to take my life. The deep surrounded me. Weeds were wrapped around my head at the roots of the mountains. I went down to the land whose bars closed upon me forever. Yet you brought up my life from the pit, O Lord my God. When my life was fainting away, I remembered the Lord, and my prayer came to you and to your holy temple. Those who pay regard to vain idols forsake their hope of steadfast love. But I, with the voice of thanksgiving, will sacrifice to you. What I have vowed, I will pay. Salvation belongs to the Lord.' And the Lord spoke to the fish, and it vomited Jonah up on dry land." Here ends our reading. So, if we could go to the next slide here. We're going to talk about Jonah, and this will just be a brief overview of Jonah's life. And what I want you to pay attention to is the ups and the downs in Jonah's life. You see, we've been talking about it in terms of our school year, the problems that we may have with COVID, things like that. But sometimes we have ups and downs in our life because of sin, things that we messed up on, things that we make mistakes with. So I want you to listen to that, and I'm going to ask you where some of these ups or downs are in. So let's begin. Jonah was a prophet of God's people. A prophet was to speak God's word, and Jonah lived a very quiet life where he was from. He didn't really want to be bothered by anybody. But God called him, and we can go to the next slide here. God called Jonah to speak to the Ninevites. You see, the Ninevites were sinful people. They were living against God's law, and God called Jonah to go to them to try to get them to repent. Does anybody know what the word repent means? Yeah. Any idea? No? Repent? How about in the back there? What's that? To forgive, yeah, to ask for forgiveness, to say, "I'm sorry." Jonah was sent to tell the people that they should say that they're sorry for their sins. Well, if we go to the next slide, Jonah didn't want to do that. He didn't want to go and to tell these people to repent. So instead of going to Nineveh, he went the opposite direction, to Tarshish. He found a ship that was sailing, and he thought maybe God would forget about him. Maybe by the time he got to Tarshish, God would have to send a different prophet, because Jonah, He didn't want to tell the people to repent. We can go to the next slide. But God wanted Jonah to go there. So he sent a great storm that affected this ship and affected Jonah. And Jonah was sleeping in the bottom of the ship. And all of a sudden, these great waves were coming up. And the people cried out, "What is going on? Where are these waves coming from? What can we do?" So we can go to the next slide. Jonah said, "It's because of me. It's because I'm not doing what God wants me to do. I'm not listening to God. That's why he sent the storm." So the people threw Jonah overboard. They threw him right into the water. Can you imagine being plunged into the deep, and he was going down deeper and deeper and deeper? Well, then God sent a whale, a great fish, who swallowed Jonah up. And Jonah was in this whale for 3 days and 3 nights. And that's when he said this prayer to God, asking for forgiveness, asking for God to forgive him because he didn't listen to God. And after 3 days, the whale spits Jonah up on the dry land, and he is saved. Jonah would have drowned if it wasn't for this whale who came to save Jonah, but God sent the whale so that he could live, and God provided for him. So then on the next slide, Jonah does go to Nineveh. He preaches to the people, tells them to be sorry for their sins, and they listen. They say to God, "We are sorry for not obeying you. Please forgive us." That would be an amazing thing for anybody to hear these people's repentance, but not to Jonah. On the next slide here, or this slide right now, Jonah was angry. You see, even though God honored the people's confession of sin, God knew that they said sorry, but Jonah, he didn't like that. You see, Jonah wanted to hold their sin against them. He thought that the Ninevites were too far gone, that they couldn't be saved, even though God forgave them. So then he's sitting out under a tree. It was a very hot day. If you've ever been out on a hot day in the sun, it can get pretty hot, right? Well, Jonah was sitting outside, and God creates this tree that blooms over him, and he provides him shade. And he's very happy about this tree because he's cooled off. But then God wanted to teach him a lesson on the next slide. God causes a worm to come up, and it eats the tree, and it causes it to die. And Jonah gets angry at God. He says, "God, why did you make this tree die? I loved this tree. Why did you cause it to die?" And here's the lesson. God says, "Jonah, do you care more about this tree than you care about my people?" You see, Jonah didn't want God's people to be forgiven. He wanted to hold their sins against them, even though that God wanted to forgive them. And even though God promised that he would not destroy the Ninevites because of their sin, Jonah thought that he wanted to hold his sin against them. So God showed Jonah through this tree that he should forgive his people. And we can go to the next slide. So, hearing the story of Jonah, there's a couple things I want to talk about. But what are some lows during Jonah's journey with God? Something from that story. Anybody? Let's go. Yeah. Exactly. Jonah wanted to go a different direction. You see, in his sin, he didn't want to do what God wanted him to do. He thought he had a better idea, and he did not want to go to God's people. So that was a low in Jonah's life, where he chose not to listen to God. What's another one? Yeah, we'll go right here. The whale. The whale. See, I think that could be a high and a low. And hear me out. The low was that Jonah was drowning, and he got in a whale. Can you imagine being in a whale? It would probably be smelly, stinky, right? It would be pretty dark in there. That would be a low. But it also could have been a high or an up, because through this whale, God saved Jonah. So it's kind of both, isn't it? Very good. Let's go. Yeah, another one. That's a very good one. You see, one of Jonah's, and the question was, why did Jonah think he had a better idea than God? Well, you see, that was his problem. You see, many of us, have you ever been in the situation where maybe you disobey your parents? Maybe your parents tell you to do some chores, but you don't really want to do them? I know I've been in that boat. But unfortunately, they know what's best. They want us to do that. And Jonah thought he knew better than God, that he could do things better than God. And of course, he can't. So he had many ups and downs in his life. So that was kind of the story of Jonah. The second thing I want to talk about was his lack of forgiveness. You see, God made Jonah go to the Ninevites, even though they were sinful people, because God wanted to forgive them. You see, God didn't want these people to be destroyed. He wanted to offer them a second chance. But Jonah didn't want that. So I want you to think about this as you go out this week. Maybe you've sinned against somebody else. Maybe you've hurt somebody's feelings. Maybe you've taken somebody's pencils, or maybe you've taken something from somebody, or maybe you said some unkind words. Or maybe somebody said unkind words to you, sinned against you. Does God want us to hold that against other people? Does he want us to not forgive others? Of course not. God wants us to forgive just as he forgives his people. And we know that he has forgiven all of us, each and every one of us. Because all of us, because of our sin, deserve nothing but God's condemnation. But God has chosen to forgive all of us through Jesus, who died on the cross for us. Because our God is a God of love, a God of forgiveness, who is with us even through the ups and the downs. Amen. We're going to say a prayer, and this time I'm going to pray a few words, and I'll just have you repeat those words, and then we'll all join in the Lord's Prayer together. So let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you for loving us and being with us during the ups and the downs. Help us to forgive other people, even when they've harmed us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now we join together in the prayer that Jesus has taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now receive the blessing of the Lord. The Lord bless you and keep all of you. May he make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with his favor and give you his peace. Amen. And now I would invite everyone to stand up, and we're going to finish with our closing song.
Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, your perfect love is casting out fear. And even when I'm caught in the middle of the storms of this life, I won't turn back, I know you are near. And I will fear no evil, for my God is with me. My God is with me. Whom then shall I fear? Whom then shall I fear? Oh, God is with me, and if my God is with me, whom then shall I fear? Whom then shall I fear? Oh no, you never let go, through the calm and through the storm. Oh no, you never let go, in every high, every low. Oh no, you never let go, Lord, you never let go of me. You keep on loving and you never let go. Singing, oh no, you never let go, through the calm and through the storm. Oh no, you never let go, in every high, every low.
All right, everybody, now you bet. Got that? Okay, that's one thing to remember. going on that are exciting. One of the things is we're going to be running in the Joggathon. Who's excited about the Joggathon? Me too. We didn't get to do that last year, so I haven't been a part of that yet. So I am so excited to see you guys do this. So that's going to be Friday for you guys. So I'm very excited about Friday. So we're looking forward to that. And then we also have something cool that is happening on Saturday. On Saturday, we have our outdoor worship service. So we're going to have church outside in the parking lot. You can come with your whole family, bring chairs, and we have a worship at 5 o'clock. And then after that, we are, the PTL is doing bingo. So you might have walked past the office and saw that table with all kinds of prizes. How many of you guys have seen that? Yes, are we excited about, if you get a bingo, those might be some of the prizes you might win if you come and play bingo with us. So that's Saturday night. So Friday and Saturday, all exciting things that are happening, which will be awesome. So hopefully you can join us, and I'll be excited to be seeing you guys run on Friday. So get your pledges in. The money that you're making for that helps us at the Redeemer. So that will be great. Okay, let's talk about what Pastor Adam said, though. He was talking about Jonah, and we were talking about forgiveness. So your challenge for this week is I'm going to guess that somebody's going to do something to you that makes you sad or hurts your feelings, or maybe even hurts you. And what I want you to think about is how God, every time we do something that makes God sad, he forgives us. So we are looking for that opportunity that you can say, I forgive you, because we know that God forgave us. So I want you to be thinking about that this week. I think the teachers will help you remind, this is a good time for you to forgive that person as we're dealing with different things. All right, so we're working on forgiveness this week. That is your challenge. If you have bags, or bring your offering in, and I will see you at the Joggathon. Let's have a good day.